who are staffers in the executive branch bureaucracy are not elected by the people. They have no accountability, and they have no legitimacy or authority that comes from an election by the people. And so it's critically important to recognize the president sets foreign policy. Of course, within some constraints, there's roles for Congress in foreign affairs to some extent. The statutes can be passed, funding provisions can be passed that relate to it. But the Supreme Court has recognized time and again that the president is, as the court said in Curtis Wright, the sole organ of the nation in foreign affairs. So he sets foreign policy. And if staffers disagree with him, that does not mean that the president is doing something wrong. And this is a critical point, because this is one of the centerpieces of the abuse of power theory that the House managers would like this body to adopt. And that is that they are going to impeach the president based solely on his subjective motive. The premise of their case is the objective actions that were taken were perfectly permissible and within the president's constitutional authority. But if his real reason, if we get inside his head and figure it out, then we can impeach him. And the way that they have tried to explain that they can prove that the president had a bad motive is they say, well, we compare what did the president want to do with what the interagency consensus was. And I mentioned this the other day. They say that the president defied and confounded every agency in the executive branch. That's a constitutionally incoherent statement. The president cannot defy the agencies within the executive branch that are subordinate to him. It is only they who can defy the president's determinations of policy. And what